we are rehearsing here and we're remembering those who were died while resisting being captured in their various villages. We'll light a candle for them. Those who died on the long trek down from their homes and the territories where they were captured and dragged down to these dungeons, we'll light a candle for them. Those who died in these dungeons and suffered and never made it out, we'll light a candle for them. Those who died along the middle passage and taking the long journey to New World, we'll light a candle for them. And we'll light a candle for those who died refusing to have their spirit to be broken, to become slaves, less slaves as free people, to be enslaved. Those who died in that resistance. Those who died in the numerous uprisings. Those who died in the numerous resistance struggles to fight for their freedom, their liberation, and their struggle. And those who died still continuing for the total emancipation and liberation of African people. And those who died that we often forget. Those who died in grief because of having lost their loved ones. Those who were separated from their families and never recovered mentally and psychologically. Those who died of that grief. They are part of the seven candles that we're lighting this evening. And now we will have a brief narrative on where we are by our brother Ethel Blyton. But we remember, when we finish playing the reeds and finish lighting the candles, we'll have a moment of silence, because nothing can compensate for the pain, the grief, and the loss that spells out this chapter. All that we're doing here tonight is symbolic, but it's a worthy symbol, because it shows that we have not forgotten. It shows that we remember. Tonight, we're not here alone. Every single one of our ancestors that have fought for African liberation and fought for African freedom, they have traveled here with us. They're here with us tonight. We invoke their spirits because we remember them and we've not forgotten them, and we'll be stronger for that. So as we're here tonight, let's put our mind in the frame of sacredness, because all the ground that we're walking on is sacred ground.
So on this gentleman, ladies and gentlemen, we will ask the Kathy College to offer libations to invite the spirit of ancestors and the spirit of the gods and the books out of the sky.
Ha! Ha! Ha!
So let's
which we offer to welcome all of us, wish us success in all our endeavors, and save the back to where we came from. We pray for the success and life of people of Kibbutz, prosperity and development of Kibbutz. We pray for myself and all and all of everybody.
Enslavement and captivity. We remember them in lighting these candles. Remember their souls, remember their spirit, remember the fire of their energy.
Let's step up. step back a bit, please. Let's go back a bit. Let's step back a bit.
On behalf of the global African family, next one on behalf of the youth of Africa. Mm-hmm. And how important these rituals are. Mm-hmm. So we'll step forward now to take and then you'll leave around.
Please, you can leave your candles, either yoga, somewhere close by. That's by the wall. Thank you.
Fiatome Monkey Sanctuary and Cultural Village. The Monkey Sanctuary is located at Tafiatome, initially worshipped and protected as gods by our forefathers. Tafiatome Monkey Sanctuary was formally identified and declared as a tourist site in 1996. The forest houses the most friendly monkey species in the country, the true Mona monkey species. A walk through the jungle makes one refreshed at the end. At Tafiatome Cultural Village, experience their rich history in storytelling, drumming, and dancing. Your best bet to know more and have fun. This campaign is brought to you by the Ghana Tourism Authority under the auspices of the Ministry of Tourism, Arts and Culture. Experience Ghana. Share Ghana. It is believed to be the second highest mountain in the Volta region and located at Ametofe. It is about 777 meters. The mountain has a cross that served as a communication tool to the Germans during colonization. Hike your way up and make the mark and make history at Mount Gemi. 5 minutes away from the mountain leads to the Ametofe canopy walk. Getting to the canopy from the entrance involves a little exercise. Briskly walk down about 259 steps to reach the canopy wall, which measures about 136 meters, and get a glimpse of a number of conserved, endemic, and endangered species like the tiger snake frog, reptiles, and amphibians. Explore the scenery.
Oh, I want to get this. Let's stay over here.
Okay.
So we lift you high to Yahweh.